New Testament 3. Are the order and detail of the Gospels true? First Steps Catholic. Are the order and details of the stories in the Gospels true? Are they true, infallibly? Well, I would answer no. Not in material detail. Simply because, I said, they are human writers who wrote. And among them, some did not even attend the events. This is the case of Saint Mark and Saint Luke. Others who attended wrote much later. That means they meditated at length. This is the case of Saint John, the events. After, they put an order, which is rather chronological, but where it puts forward what seems essential, in its Christian mediation, inspired by the Holy Spirit. Then I would like to give some small details that show that we really should not focus on these historical things that are not a total historical precision, they are rather testimonies, historical investigations, that is what Saint Luke did, etc. Well, at the beginning of the Gospel according to Saint John, almost after the wedding of Cana, Jesus hunts the merchants of the temple. He takes a whip. He sees that people make the house of God a trading house, he drives them out. Well, in the other Gospels, it happens at the end of the apostolic life of Jesus, before his passion. Who is right? Some would say Saint John, he attended the events. But that's not necessarily true. It may be that Saint John puts this event first because he seems to him founder. So he puts an order of perfection, while the others may have been more entails according to the order of what happened. Similarly, there are sometimes details that are told in Saint John, for example, when Jesus said to his mother, compared to John, here is your son. He says to Saint John, here is your mother, and John takes Mary home. Why does he tell him? Because he was there and he was deeply touched by that which marked his whole life. The other three Gospels do not tell this story. Does that mean it did not happen? No. As in the testimonies, each puts forward what seems to him essential. There are therefore real human authors, and as in human testimonies, the order is different. What is certain, however, is that the message of the Gospel, the message concerning the doctrine of salvation, what salvation is, how to obtain salvation, even through these imperfections, has been infallibly taught by the Holy Spirit, but beware, infallibly put into this text, but dead in himself. So to find things, it is necessary that the principal author, the Holy Spirit, inspires again who reads the Gospel, otherwise we do not understand anything. A veil over the eyes, and one can take a detail as the key to all the Gospel. That is why the Gospel, for believers, reads with the Church, so that the tradition, carried by great saints, but the saints themselves are not infallible, and that is why there is the charism of the Pope, the Magisterium. I prayed that your faith will not fail, said Jesus to Saint Peter. While Peter denied it right after. It is not therefore his personal faith that is protected. It is when he teaches the doctrine of salvation, of his pulpit of Pope. So he confirms his brothers in their assumptions, this is true, this is not true.